I saw it blaze, the holy flame that called from hell and valley, the brave and true in Ireland's name, to Ireland's cause to rally. I saw them haste from mountain glen, a solemn sight to see. Men march proudly on for freedom. They met within a valley where the slaney shining river all softly throws upon the air the selfsame chorus ever. And through the night I could decry my father. Silently to listen, they marched away, the music died, thy father, heaven speed him, is gone tonight, my mother cried, to fight for Ireland's freedom. Tomorrow proudly shall arise by mountain hill and
breaks the silence like a bitter last hurrah, and the raven spreads its wings for flight over fields near Belnaplaw, with the rifle still clasped to his breast, but hanging low his head. A black August day in the county court, Michael Collins is dead. Hang out your brightest colors, his memory now recall. Oh, each one wants a part of him, no one wants it all. Working over in London town when he joined the IRB, swore to use most deadly force his native land to free. His squad is ready and willing to strike, he has love for his ruthless charm. The laughing boy smiles at the castle. It's a smile to cause alarm. Hang out your brightest colors, his memory now recall. Oh, each one wants a part of him, no one wants it all. A British intelligence agent is working from a Dublin room. Michael Collins adds a name to a list that will take men to the tomb. A spy slowly rises from his chair, walks across the floor. A man with a parabellum is knocking at the door. Hang out your brightest colors, his memory now recall. Oh, each one wants a part of him, no one wants it all. Returning then to London town, who will take the blame? The treaty lies before him, Michael Collins adds his name. There's a darker time upon the land, who will bear the load? An awkward hero in an armored car on an Irish country road. Hang out your brightest colors, his memory now recall. For each one wants a part of him, no one wants it all. The bark of a dog breaks the silence like a bitter last hurrah. And a raven spreads its wings for flight over fields near Belnablah.
Was down by the glen side I met an old woman, plucking young nettles. Now she saw I was coming. I listened a while to the song she was humming. Glory, side, sun's awesome and thrilling, but they love poor old Ireland, and to die they were willing. Glory, men. Some died by the glen side, some died by the stranger, and the wise men have told us that their cause was a failure. But they love poor Ireland. Sure, they'd never fear danger. Glory, ho, glory, ho, the Bullfinian man. I went on my way, God be praised that I met her, be my life long or sure, I shall never forget her. Though we may have brave men, still we'll never have better. Glory, oh, glory, oh, to the Bullfinian man.
Friends of the great North Sea. Oh, had they died by Pearson's side, or fought with Athelbrough, their names we would keep where the Fenians sleep, neath the shroud of the foggy dew. But the bravest fell, and the requiem bell rang mournful. Springtime of the year, while the world did gaze with deep amaze at those fearless men of few, who bore the fight that freedom's light might shine through the foggy dew. Back to the glen I rode again, and my heart with grief was sore. Huggy.
Calgary crowd had gathered outside of Kilmallham with their heads all uncovered. They knelt on the ground, for inside that grim prison lay a brave army soldier, his life for his country about to lay down. He went to his death like a true son of Ireland, the firing party he gravely did face. Then the order rang out, present arms and fire. James Conley fell into a ready made grave. Now the black flag was hoisted, the cruel deed was over, and gone was the man who loved Ireland so well. There were many a sad heart in Dublin that morning when they murdered James Conley, the Irish rebel. God's curse on you, England, you cruel hearted monsters. Your deeds they would shame all the devils in hell. There are no flowers blooming, but the shamrock is growing on the grave of James Conley, the Irish rebel. Many years have gone by since the Irish rebellion, when the guns of Britannia they loudly did speak, when the bold IRA shoulder to shoulder, and the blood from their bodies flowed down Sackville
Easter morn, when Irish men are proud and glad of a land where they were born. Oh son, I see in memory's view of a far off distant day, when being just a lad like you, I joined the IRA. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Cromachree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade. From hills and farms, the call to arms was heard by one and all. From the glen came brave young men to answer Ireland's call. It was long ago we faced a foe, the old brigade and me. And by my side they fought and died that Ireland might be free. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Cromachree, Cree, I long to see the pies of the old brigade. Now, my boy, I've told you why on Easter morn I sigh. For I recall my comrades all in those dark, dull days gone by. I think of men who fought in Glen with rifle and grenade. May heaven keep those men who sleep from the ranks of the old brigade. Where are the lads who stood with me when history was made? Oh, Cromachree, I long to see the boys of the old brigade.
Town. When the green flag went up and the crown rag came down, was the neatest and sweetest thing ever you saw. When we played the best game, played in Erin go braw. God rest Galen Pierce and his comrades who died. McDonough McBride. And here's to James Connolly, who gave one hurrah, and he placed the machine guns for Erin go braw. Well, one of our leaders was down at Ringsend for the honour of Ireland to hold and defend. Soldiers but volunteers are all playing sweet Mauser music for Erin go braw. Old Kent and his comrades like lions at bay, from the South Dublin Union poured death and dismay. Ah, but what was their wrath when the Englishmen saw all the dead Kharki soldiers in Erin go braw. Oh, a brave English captain was raving that day. He says, give me one oar and I'll blow you away. But a big Mauser bullet got stuck in his craw, and he died of lead poisoning in Erin go braw. All glory to Dublin, to the halls of renown. In the long generations her fame won't live down, and children will tell how their forefathers saw the red blaze of freedom o'er Erin go braw.
Cold May morn was breaking over Dublin's weary town. 16 brave men have fallen to the rifles of the crown, because they loved their country and served it night and day. But before they faced the rifles, this is what those boys did say.
Take away the blood-stained bandage from off an Irish brow. We fought and bled for Ireland, and we will not shirk it now. We have held her in her struggle, in an answer to her call. And because we sought to free her, we are placed against the wall.
Ned Daly, Houston, Culver, McDonough and McBride, McDermott and the brothers Kent, with Clark and Plunkett died. McMahon, Pat and Bully Pierce, O'Hanrahan and Kien, and the last of all, James Connolly, this message to them send.
Take away the blood-stained bandage from off an Irish brow. We fought and bled for Ireland, and we will not shirk it now. We upheld her in her struggle, in answer to her call. And because we sought to free her, we are placed against the wall. Take away the blood-stained bandage from off an Irish brow. We fought and bled for Ireland, and we will not shirk it now. We upheld her in her struggle, in answer to her call. And because we sought to free her, we are placed against the wall.
Dearest mother, I am writing just to say I won't be home. There is something that I have to do, and I must do alone. They took me and they put me in this lonely prison cell. Tonight my thoughts are with you as I say my last farewell. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget and Michal. I have no words to tell you how much I'll miss you all. Although I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. Dearest brother, won't you take good care of all the folks for me? Go home to Rathfarnham on the day they set you free. I was happy when you stood by me in all that we've been through. No one has ever had so true a brother such as you. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget and Michal. I have no words to tell you how much I'll miss you all. Although I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. Dearest mother, it's so very sad that now we have to part. To understand the reasons that trouble your poor heart. I have told you since I was a boy it was my destiny to die a true brave soldier, so that one day you'd be free. So say goodbye to Margaret, Mary, Bridget and me all. I have no words to tell you how much I'll miss you all. Although I may not show it, you know I love you well. So in my final letter, I will bid my last farewell. In my final letter, I will bid my last farewell.
There's a sacred spot in Dublin, a place called Arbor Hill, where sleep our noble martyrs, but their message rings out still. To you their message calling, as it did that Easter day, when they flew the flag of freedom and proclaim the IRA. They marched, those men in Dublin, and for Ireland struck a blow. They cherished it and raised it over Dublin's GPO. Traitors tried to sell the cause, traitors they may be, for Connolly had one in mind, old Ireland's liberty. They followed Tone and Emmet, and they faced a martyr's grave. We again must take their message, if our nation we must save. Six counties still subjected, and are held by England still. So wake up and show devotion to the men in Arbor Hill.
In the streets of Dublin City, early rose the morning sun. Stood a gallant band of soldiers, each man proudly held a gun. Till the last they fought them bravely, standing staunch and fighting true. In their midst there stood a leader, Ireland's dauntless Cahalbrew. Another faithful son of Ireland, by the traitor's hand shut down. One of Ireland's best and bravest, in heaven wears the martyr's crown. Till he died he fought them bravely, to the old cause he was true. Dashing forth he fell in action, Ireland's dauntless Cahalbrew. when they battered on the forecourts with their borrowed British guns. Traitors in the pay of England shot down Ireland's faithful sons. When they called on them surrender, we are many, you're but few. We'll have death before dishonor, proudly answered Cahill Brew, you'll be remembered in our Irish hearts with pride. For the blood you shed in Dublin, Ireland's cause you sanctified. When they laid him low in agony, neath an Irish sky of blue, tell them all I die for Ireland, softly murmured Cahill Brew.
As we gather in this chapel here, in old Kilmainham jail, I think about these past few weeks. Oh, will they say we failed? From our school days they have told us we must yearn for liberty. Yet all I want in this dark place is to have you here with me. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, so we must say goodbye. Oh, I know it's hard for you, my love, to ever understand the love I bear for these brave men, my love for this dear land. But when Parry called me to his side down in the GPO, I had to leave my own sick bed. To him I had to go. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, so we must say goodbye. At last the dawn is breaking, my heart is breaking too. As I walk out this May morning, my thoughts will be of you. And I'll write some words upon the wall, so everyone will know I love so much that I could see is blood upon the rose. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love I'll place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, so we must say goodbye.
The night was dark and the fight was over. The moon shone down O'Connell Street. I stood alone where brave men perished. Those men have gone, they're God to me. My only son was shot in Dublin, fighting for his country bold. He fought for Ireland and Ireland only. The harp and shamrock, green, white and gold. The first I met was a grey-haired father searching for his only son. I said, old man, there's no use searching, for up to heaven your son has gone. The old man cried out broken hearted, bending o'er, I heard him say, son was too kind-hearted. I knew my son would never yield. The last I met was a dying rebel, bending low, heard him say, God bless my home in dear Cork City. God bless the cause for which I
died. Was on Good Friday morning, all in the month of May, a German ship was signaling beyond there in the bay. We've 20,000 all ready for to land. But no answering signal did come from the lonely Bannerstrand. A motor car came dashing through the early morning gloom. A sudden crash and in the stream they went to meet their doom. Two Irish lads lay dying there, just like their hope so grand. They could not give the signal now from the lonely Bannerstrand. No signal answers from the shore, Sir Roger sadly said. No comrade here to welcome me. Alas, they must be dead. But I must do my duty, and at once I mean to land. So in a boat he pulled ashore to the lonely Bannerstrand. The German ship was lying there with rifles by the score. Up came a British ship and said, no Germans reached the shore. You are our empire's enemy, and so we bid you stand. No German food shall e'er pollute the lonely Bannerstrand. They sailed for Queenstown Harbor, said the Germans, we're undone. The British are our masters, man for man and gun for gun. We've 20,000 rifles here, but they never will reach land. We'll sink them all and bid farewell to the lonely Bannerstrand. They took Sir Roger prisoner, and they sailed for London town. And in the Tower they laid him as a traitor to the crown. Said he, I am no traitor, but his trial he had to stand for bringing German rifles to the lonely Bannerstrand. 'Twas in an English prison that they led him to his death. I'm dying for my country, he said with his last breath. He's buried in a prison yard, far from his name. native land. And the wild waves sing his requiem on the lonely Bannastrand.
At Easter time, 1916, when flowers bloom and trees were green, there dawned the day when freedom's cry called out brave men to fight and die. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men who traded their chains for guns. Born into slavery, they were freedom's sons. In Dublin town, they fought and died with Pierce, McDermott, and McBride. Ourselves alone, their battle cry, and freedom sang to the Easter sky. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men who traded their chains for guns. Born into slavery, they were freedom's sons. A poet's dream had sparked the flame, a raging fire that soon became. And from that fire, all deaths that he, proud and free. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men who traded their chains for guns. Born into slavery, they were freedom's sons. Six counties are in bondage still. Those men who died, was this their will? Until they're free, oppression cease, only then can they rest in peace. They were the men with the vision, the men with the cause, the men who defied their oppressors' laws, the men traded their chains for guns. Born to slavery, they were freedom's sons.
Oh, I am a merry plowboy, and I plow the fields all day.
Who fears to speak of East our week, that week of famed renown? When the boys in green, they went out to fight the forces of the crown. With Mausers bold and hearts of gold, the Red Countess dressed in green, and high above the GPO, the rebel flag was seen. Then came 10,000 khaki coats, our rebel boys to kill. Before they reached O'Connell Street, of fight they got their fill. They machine guns and artillery and cannon in galore, but it wasn't our fault that Erewhon got back to England's shore. For 6 long days we held them off at odds of 10-1, and through our lines they could not pass for all of their heavy guns. And deadly poison gas they used to try and crush in vain, and burdened our Irish capital like the Germans did Louvain. The Anglo-Saxons make great contributions to culture, don't they? They shot our leaders in a jail without a trial, they say. They murdered women and children who in their cellars lay. They dug the grave with gun and spade to hide them from our view, because they could neither kill nor catch the rebels so bold and true. But we will love old Ireland and shall while life remain, and we will say Godspeed the day the rebels will rise again. The Irish slaves and English knaves may try you to deceive. Remember those who died for you, and likewise James Connolly's grave.
When boyhood's fire was in my blood, I read of ancient freemen, for Greece and Rome, who bravely stood, 300 men and 3 men. And then I prayed I yet might see our feathers rent in twain, and Ireland long a province be, a nation once again, a nation once again, a nation once again. And Ireland long a province be, a nation once again. And from that time through wildest woe, that hope has shone a far light, nor could love's bright summer glow outshine that solemn starlight. It seemed to watch above my head in foreign field and fane. Its angel voice sang round my bed, a nation once again, a nation once again, a nation once again. And Ireland long a province be, a nation once again. It whispered to that freedom's heart, that serviced high and holy, would be profaned by feelings dark and passion vain or lowly. For freedom comes from God's right hand and needs a godly train, and righteous men must make our land a nation once again, a nation once again, a nation once again. And Ireland long a province be, a nation once again, a nation once again, a nation once again. And Ireland long a province be, a nation once again.
High upon the gallows tree swung the noble-hearted three, by the vengeful tyrant stricken in their bloom. But they met him face to face with the spirit of their race, and they went with souls undaunted to their doom. And love them far and near, of the millions true and brave, o'er the ocean's swelling wave, and the friends in holy Ireland never near. God save Ireland, say they proudly. God save Ireland, say we all. Whether on the scaffold high or the battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for air and fear we fall? Climb they up the rugged stair, in prayer, then with England's fatal cord around them cast, close beside the gallows tree, kissed like brothers lovingly, true to home and faith and freedom to the last. God save Ireland, pray they loudly. God save Ireland, say we all. Whether on the scaffold high or the battlefield we die, oh, what matter when for air and dear we fall?
Sing a soldier's song, with cheering, rousing chorus, as round our blazing fires we throng, the starry heavens o'er us, impatient for the coming fight, and as we wait the morning's light. Here in the silence of the night, we will chant a soldier's song. Soldiers are we, whose lives are pledged to Ireland. Some have come from the land beyond the wave, sworn to be free. No more our ancient Ireland shall shelter the despot or the slave. Tonight we'll man the Barnacle, in Erin's cause come woe or will. Mid cannon roar and rifle peal, we will chant the soldier's song. In valley green, our towering crag, our fathers fought before us and conquered neath the same old flag that proudly floating o'er us. We're children of a fighting race that never yet has known disgrace. And as we march the foe to face, we will chant a soldier's song. Soldiers are we, whose lives are pledged to Ireland. Some have come from the land beyond the wave, sworn to be free. No more our ancient sire land shall shelter the despot or the slave. Tonight we'll man the Barnacle, and Ireland's cause come o'er. we will chant a soldier's song.